praise the Lord on an instrument of 10 strings, a harp and the timbrel and the pipes. We can use these musical gifts for a holy God to glorify our Creator, because God who gave us these gifts, otherwise it is vain glory. So you must give glory to the Lord your God today. And that's, you can't earn it from God. It's what God has done in Christ to reconcile the world back to himself. Those who believe in him will be justified by faith. The gift of God is eternal life in Christ Jesus our Lord. Come to the Lord Jesus Christ today to be reconciled to God. It is in him that is life, and this life is the light of men. So whatever we do it heartily as to the Lord, not to men, he says in Colossians, and he also says in 1 Corinthians 10, he says, whether eating or drinking or all that we do it for the glory of God. We do everything for the glory of God. When we're born again by the grace of God, and the things we don't do for the glory of God that are vanity will burn in the fire. But it is not by works of righteousness which we have done, but according to his mercy he saves us. Through the washing of regeneration, renewing of the Holy Ghost. Think about that. If you died today, where would you go? Are you ready to meet your God? Right now, you have no assurance of your salvation. If God were to require your soul, like last night, there was a big accident up there in Linwood, Washington. A few kids were in a car, 15 years old, about your age. And they were speeding. I don't know exactly what happened. It was on the news earlier today. They went underneath a semi-truck. Everybody was killed except one girl miraculously lived. They didn't know when they got in that car today they were going to die this morning at 4:30 a.m. in the morning. But they were suddenly destroyed without remedy. It's a tragedy. Now, what about you? You don't know the day or the hour God's going to require your soul or when Jesus is going to return again. The most important thing is you live for God now. You need to serve God. We can't just play church on Sunday, act like a religious people, and then the inside be hypocrites. Are we really saved? Are we really born again? Are we really living for the Lord as a result of the life of Christ in you? Christ in you, the hope of glory. Now, fear God and give glory to him. Did you guys get a paper? Get along with God. Praise God. Fear God and give glory to him. He says, fear God and keep his commandments, but this is the whole duty of man, for God will bring every work into judgment, including every secret thing, whether good or evil. As the scripture declares that all the gods of the nations are idols, but the Lord made the heavens. The Lord is the true God. He is the living God and the everlasting King. At his wrath, the earth will tremble and the nations will not be able to endure his indignation. God is jealous and the Lord revengeth. The Lord revengeth and is furious. He will take vengeance on his adversaries. He reserveth wrath for his enemies. That means every person right now on this road, on Greenwood Avenue and in the world today, that is outside of Jesus Christ is a true enemy of God. And the wrath of God abides upon them to be poured out upon them on the day of judgment. Now, today if you will hear his voice, do not harden your hearts. Humble yourself under the mighty hand of God. Turn from your evil ways. Turn. That evil way is rebellion against God. Our lives are defiant towards God. It's our inclinations and all of our actions to live apart from God, doing our own will, like we're God. And that is the indictment that God has against you. We exchange the truth of God for the lie. I am the Lord your God. You should have no other gods before me is the first commandment. There's no other God but the one true God who made the heavens and the earth and the sea and all that's within them. For he spoke and it was done. He commanded and it stood fast. For the Lord brings the counsel of the nations to nothing and the plans of the peoples to none effect. The Lord God stretches out the heavens like a curtain. All the nations are a drop in the bucket to God. Oh, if you weigh together, you put them all together on a scale, they're lighter than vapor. They're like dust on the scales, folks. This creator of the universe with billions of light years of galaxies that are just a billboard for his holy name and his mighty power. As Isaiah cried out, lift up your eyes on high and see who has created these things. Who brings out their hosts by number, he calls them all by name. By the greatness of his might and the strength of his power, not one of them is missing. He knows every star by name, knows every hair on your head, knows you by name, knows you before you were in the mother's womb, he fashioned you. Oh yes, vessels of honor, vessels of dishonor, all for the glory of God in the end. The one who made all things and to bring all things into judgment, all things will be before the throne of God. There'll be no injustice done, no appeal. And that final judgment, Jesus said, you must be born again. You need the righteousness of Jesus Christ, God the Son, who became man, who lived perfectly as a man, who died innocently, fully God and fully man, to bear the sins of his people. He bore the wrath of God. He appeased the wrath of holy God through his atoning death. He conquered Satan in the grave and sin by rising from the dead. Anyone who calls upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. Call upon the name of the Lord. You don't know, your time is short here. It says, for what is your life? For he is even a vapor. It appears for a little time, and then it vanishes away. In the end, you lose everything. In the end, everything you came, you have acquired here on the earth. Everything that you've attained here will one day be gone. It will burn in the fire, including both soul and body in hell.
Don't touch me.
The both soul and the body, apart from Jesus Christ, will perish. And so God will render punishment to the proud. So we know that we only have a short time here.
Give it a break. God is dead.
We only have a short time on this earth. So don't lose your soul. Don't die in your sins. That's what we are, folks. Apart from Christ.
Jesus killed my son. Jesus killed my son.
Yes. That's what we are. We're clowns outside of Christ. Clowning around.
Where was Jesus?
Our lives are clowning around upon the true living God. God is holy. Yeah, just to give you a reason to go sin against God and forsake God. But folks, we thank God for... Don't touch anything.
Don't touch me.
We thank God for his unspeakable gift again here today. Don't harden your hearts, folks. And again, in the end, you'll lose it all. Of that. Even both soul and body. Yeah, once it starts, that's right. God is commanding you personally to repent today. So lies, in the end we lose everything, including both soul and body, a resurrected body to damnation, to suffer the eternal conscious torment of the lake of fire. And it will be a reality. So you need to be saved. You're to return to the living God. Your only hope is Jesus Christ, the Son of God, who paid the penalty for sin in full. There's no more offerings for sin. As the scripture says in Hebrews, every priest stands daily. Ministering daily, offering repeatedly the same sacrifices which could never take away sins. But this man, the Lord Jesus Christ, after he offered himself once for sins forever, sat down at the right hand of God. He rules the universe. There's no more sacrifices for sins. Folks, receive him today. The Lord Jesus Christ is your King, and every knee will bow to him. Every tongue will confess that he's God. If you don't bow in this life, he will break your knee with a rod of iron. You'll be forced to bow at the tribunal of God, the great white throne of judgment, and then you'll be cast into the lake of fire. Flee from the wrath to come. Ladies and gentlemen, seek the Lord and live. Be reconciled to God today. You must surrender to the Lord Jesus Christ, because you don't know the day or the hour. He'll require your soul to take you out this planet. Today is the day of salvation. Now is the acceptable time. Give glory to the Lord your God. If you have ears to hear, hear what the Word of God says today. The Lord Jesus said, my sheep hear my voice. I know them, and they follow me, and I give them eternal life, and they shall never perish. Neither shall anyone snatch them out of my hand. In the book of Hebrews, he says, if the word spoken through angels proved steadfast, and every transgression and disobedience received a just recompense of reward, how shall we escape if we neglect so great a salvation, of which it first began to be spoken by the Lord and was confirmed by those who heard him? God also bearing witness of signs and wonders and various miracles and gifts of the Holy Ghost according to his own will. Folks, we're not going to escape that day. There's going to be no one to plead your cause. What will you do with all your sins? Folks, without an advocate, without a redeemer, a mediator, you are guilty before God with no one to stand before God to plead your case. It is only the advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ the righteous, for those who believed upon him, that will cover your sins and take them away because he paid for them. If you don't come to him, your sins remain. You're still in your sins. If you do not believe that I am, he said, you will die in your sins. And the Lord Jesus Christ is your God. And so come to him to have your sins pardoned and be reconciled to God, even remembered no more. Believe on him who justifies the ungodly, and your faith will be accounted for righteousness. That's the gift of God, the unspeakable gift of God, that the Lord Jesus Christ came into this world to save his people from their sins. Have you received him? Don't harden your necks. The more of this you heard in your life, the more accountable you are, and the greater your judgment will be. For the truth you've heard, you've rejected. Reconciliate con Dios. Arrepiéntete. Y cree en el Evangelio de Jesucristo. Gloria a Dios. Jesucristo es el camino, la verdad y la vida. Jesucristo es Señor. Recibe la salvación en Jesucristo today. Now is the acceptable time. So God commands you to repent and believe the gospel. It's alarm. The alarm is being sounded. Watchman's on the wall. Where are you at with God today? Where do you stand with the holy God who made you today? Are you right with him? Have you been born again of his spirit? If not, you're in great danger on the way to burn the devil's hell. And there is no other name under heaven given among men by which we must be saved. The Lord Jesus Christ is the true and living God. If you don't have him, you don't have life today. And the hour is coming in which all who are in the grave will hear his voice and come forth. To those who've done, guys, believe on the Lord Jesus Christ. And now, guys, you read these Bible papers, okay? Look at this. Friends, I'm reading this. So again, Jesus came to save sinners, okay? We sin against God. No one is good. That's why everybody dies. Second death is hell. Jesus died on the cross to pay the penalty for sin. Those who receive him will be forgiven and right with God and have a personal relationship with the Holy God. That's why you're here. That's why you guys are alive. Gloria a Dios. Reconciliate con Dios. Say thank you, Lord Jesus. Leer la Biblia, okay? Read the Bible. You read the Bible and know the ways of God. God bless you. Yeah. Leer, vamos a la Biblia. Yeah, praise God, guys, in Jesus' name. Yeah, we thank God for the police serving the community. Many of us are unthankful for that. We must be thankful for that because there's protection there. So we need to be grateful. God has given you so many things you take for granted in this life. Even today, you woke up this morning, you didn't think about God at all. Think of the food that he gave you, the taste buds to eat with and savor. You didn't think of the eyes he gave you to see his beauty and creation. We have to have spiritual eyes to see the glory of God. We're born of the Spirit, and then we see the kingdom of God. We live for the kingdom of God over the things of this world. If anyone desires to come after the Lord Jesus Christ, he said, let him deny himself, take up his cross daily, and follow me. Are you doing that? Repent and live.